Once we've keyed out the soil moisture regime, it's a similar process to key out the soil nutrient regime. So here's a subset of the key again. So we start off with, is it a wet soil? And again, that might seem a little vague, but if we look back, there's a definition for it. So a wet soil is soil that has a growing season water table less than 30 centimeters from the ground surface. So in our case, we had a well-drained soil, and we had no glane or signs of major seeps. So we're going to say this was not a wet soil. Next, is the soil depth less than 30 centimeters? And it was 29 centimeters, so yes. Is the forest floor a moor? And we had a motor, so that's not the case. So is the soil dark-colored, or is there an AH horizon greater than 5 centimeters? And this or is important, remember. Sometimes these things will say and sometimes they'll say or. If it's something and something else, both of those things have to be true. If it's something or something, just one has to be true. So in our case, we have an AH of 3 centimeters, so not quite 5 centimeters, so it doesn't quite fulfill that criterion. And the AH and BM horizons are dark-colored. And we're going to assume that we used our Munsell chart and figured out the color in the field to see if it was a value less than 4. But for argument's sake, we might say, okay, maybe the soil was a little bit borderline, and we had a small AH horizon, not quite 5, so maybe we're going to be borderline here. Just to play it safe, we're going to say, okay, we can't quite tell. We're going to say it's either D, rich, or C, medium. So now that we've figured out the SMR and SNR, we can open up our edotopic grid, and remember that there's a separate edotopic grid for every subzone or variant. So in this case, we have the grid for CWHVM1, which we've established is our biogeoclimatic unit. Our SMR, or soil moisture regime, was a 3, or submesic. And remember, we have relative soil moisture regimes and actual soil moisture regimes. And that key was for a relative soil moisture regime. So based on this edotopic grid, we can see that a relative soil moisture regime of 3 corresponds to an actual soil moisture regime of F for fresh. Keep in mind that these relationships vary between biogeoclimatic units, so the relative and actual, a relative of 3 isn't always going to be fresh, for example, so you need to look it up on the edotopic grid for the biogeoclimatic unit that you're considering. For our soil nutrient regime, we were kind of undecided between C, medium, and D, rich. So for our site series, we have two possibilities, CWHVM1/01 for a site association of 01, or a site association of 05. Perhaps the subsequent analysis will help us decide between one of these.